foe for down. Digging through the court to see the light. Let's get out of here, babe. That's the way to survive.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the beach party. Fun facts about the beach party. This is the second time we have a beach party. I just said beach party four times. But yeah, the original beach party pay-per-view happened in season one, and it happened because Rara at the time was doing like a beach party mafia game or something, and that's why I made that a pay-per-view. But this is also the first time we're back on Earth since the last episode of season one. Because we've been on the moon since. We're on Earth now because of reasons. Because I thought a beach party would suck without a beach or a blue sky. But yep, since this is a pay-per-view for which nobody has to pay to view it, I will make generous use of my bottle of wine that I have. The can that I opened for show was just a Coke. Yes, our second match of the night is the Kawhi title match. Nadira versus Tolvi. Tolvi, of course, has had a good run so far. And then you have the usual DCB tries to win match. And for some reason, Lord Convoluter gets a title shot at the LP Superstar title against Toad. And the Bunny Championship Superstar, the longest reigning Bunny Champion, goes against Fruit Sniffer for the title. Yes, and of course, previously they were the tag team champion as the Aura 66, but now they are the first Aura. Kylo Ren and Face challenge for the titles again. And the big bad grudge match of some crazy drunk Scotsman and Tommy Wiseau. And there can be no peace on Earth without pro wrestling. But finally, Valerie Easton and Helena go one-on-one for the LPFLA Women's title in a match where they fight each other despite being a couple. Or because of that, I don't know. Relationships can be complicated. But first, this match. These aren't the people in it, I was just too lazy to make a banner. Mainly because I would have to make a cutout for this guy. And I didn't want to spend time on that. I mean, fruit, I don't make pay-per-view money. And for some reason, the game screwed up the entrance for Stone Cold Big Boss Man Nakamura. I don't know why. Oh yeah, that's right. But for some, like, normally the entrance theme is supposed to change. Like, it starts out with the Big Boss Man theme, then goes to the Stone Cold theme, and in the ring to the Shinsuke Nakamura theme. It really is a shame that we don't get to see it in its full glory, but that's okay. We can fix it another time. Fruity, you just bet $7 on option 10, which doesn't exist. Just FYI. I appreciate the thought, though. I think Big Boss Man does the Nakamura entrance better than Shinsuke Nakamura. Just look at this. Good shit. Very good. Alright, let's do this. I might be biased, but there's this guy in the red jacket who I think totally has this in his back. I mean, there's also the longest reigning LP Superstar Champion, The Tree, who had like 5 defenses. And now he's in this match. And also longest reigning Buskus Champion in the same match, Bone Pimp. He's truly the best of the best. Let's see who else we have here. The second longest reigning Buskus Champion, Lotus, who also goes against Shane McMahon later tonight. Right now he's just beating up on Skier. Oh yeah, I hit Big Boss Man. I'm such a good, like, wrestler and stuff. Oh yeah, when was Skier's last appearance before this? We'll find out. Right.
Hello.
Hello. You missed an entrance, that's it.
Ah.
Aside from that, everything is, you know. Anyway, I was about to look something up. Let me check. I want to see how long it was since Skier's last match before this.
That's been a while.
Indeed. Episode 19. Oh man, that actually is a while. I didn't mean to underutilize him so much, but I did.
Well, stuff happens.
Yep, shit happens. I'm probably not gonna use him for like 10 more episodes, and then he'll make a big comeback, claiming that he never lost some title that he never won. But you know,
I see Anil has recovered from his severe beating at the hands of Toad.
Wait, who got beaten up by Toad again? I can't keep track.
Anil.
Oh right, he got squashed completely. Oh, it's good.
Yes.
Ooh, Lotus just did his finisher, but of course it whiffed. Like, it's an Imploder 450, and he hit the mat with it. Aw, yeah, I did my signature on Big Boss Man. Yeah. Do it, pin him, Iggy, pin him, Iggy!
You appear to just be staring at him.
Yeah, I want a little break. It's hot outside, you know.
Sure is. Ooh. An MGM.
Out of nowhere?
What? Kinda.
Ooh. Oh. I made Big Boss Man bleed. Too Ooh. Sweet.
Toad. Freaking murdered. Macro Man. just staring at him now.
I did my finisher, the hangover. Big Boss Man, die.
1, 2, 3. Yep.
I pinned
he's
Big Boss
here.
Man, which is hilarious because he's the character I have to control during Fight Me Mate. Matches because, you know, he's the current Fight Me Mate champion.
Tree is kicking the ropes. Now he's down here.
Who's bleeding?
Ooh,
someone's bleeding.
Bleeding.
Maybe.
Macroman tried to steal pin from Tree.
It happens. My My favorite part about these matches is that as the hurt thins out, it gets easier to follow.
Yeah.
Then again, I kind of like just looking into the chaos.
Trying to figure out what's happening. Like you, right now, just destroying Lotus.
Yep, that was my signature move.
Immediately getting tombstone by Aquaman.
I get just, yeah, pile driven. Oh, my foot is on skier. Ooh. Oh, you see that? As he kicked out my leg and lifted up in the air. Ooh, a weird knee to the face from Anil out of nowhere. And now the that's not an Explorer suplex, that's something different. Whatever. It was an interesting pinfall attempt. Oh, well, I'm running this on the PS4 version of the game.
Oh.
But it's all pre-recorded, because this is a work.
Yes. Except for the times when it's the shoot.
Which happens frequently, yeah. I mean, in a way, it happens frequently. You just don't know, because it's hidden so well.
Ooh.
Fruity kayfabe is already dead, and yeah.
Kenny Omega killed it.
Actually, it was the click who killed it, but you know, I mean, I would have no problem with Kenny Omega just killing kayfabe for good, as long as it makes Cornet angry.
Yeah. What you were doing there, but she immediately stopped it.
Ooh, Skiers is the space funeral on Macroman, and immediately goes to not pinning him. Very good. I am impressed with Skiers. Oh, now he's got a knee to the head or his helmet, whatever.
Oh,
something happened.
Yeah, Anil's going to Macroman.
This is actually on Earth. Like, this one show is.
Brokered a deal with the Earth officials to let you back on for one night.
I mean, I'm only banned from Montreal, not from any other place in the world.
One, two,
Still kicking out. I mean, it's Earth, let's put it that way. There's blue sky and there's sand. We might be on a completely different planet, also called Earth, for all we know, but whatever.
Ooh, just did a running dive thing to the tree. Immediately went after Bone Pimp. Oof, I reversed the move on you, I'm not sure.
I don't understand what that move is.
Two.
That was a dirty pin, it never works, come on. Don't even count it. Ooh, I got treed, oh no. And the tree ignores me, thankfully, otherwise I'd be dead. I mean, I'm dead anyway, but I would also lose. Oh, who got pinned? Oh, Bone Pimp got pinned. Well, he wasn't the first to be eliminated. Yeah, he did, just now.
Oh.
He was hidden behind the tree, so nobody noticed. Oh, and Plota for and the mat again. This is not Lotus's day.
You're just trying to grab a ghost.
Yeah, I mean, I got hit in the head pretty bad, so what else am I gonna do? Pile driver to the frickin' tree. And I'm still trying to grab the ghost. Can I win against the ghost? Oh, I did a finisher on Anil and I don't pin him. What the fuck? Come on.
Oh, now you are.
Yeah.
One, two.
Ooh, Andy kicks out. He is notoriously resilient.
Except for that time he fought Toad.
Or that one time, yeah. That wasn't a good showing for him.
Hopper up something.
Rainmaker!
And an elbow to tree.
One, two,
three. Nah.
Oh, I'm getting annealed. One, two,
three.
Nope.
That's just so close.
No one wants to actually lose here, apparently. Which makes sense because the object of the game is to win, but
this isn't WWE where wins and losses don't matter.
Yeah. Yep.
River Pin, Boss Man, and Bone Pimp.
Bone Pimp. I think it was Macro Man and Boss Man. I have no idea. I pinned Boss Man. Yeah, I'm so good. I forgot.
Lotus is going for something.
He's, He's actually going for something. Oh my god! Everybody hates gear! And now, oh my god, Lotus is coming again!
He's going for you, actually.
That would have been too good if they just ganged up on gear completely.
Yeah.
Like, just completely ganging up on one single guy with every move they have. Oh. Reversal. One, two.
Ref, you have two hands. You could have counted both those at the same time.
I technically have, but you're asking a lot of the game.
Oh, now she's bleeding. Zap, I guess.
Oh, I think it was another space funeral. I just glanced away for a second, so I don't know.
One, two.
That is fascinating.
Oh no.
This is our first on-screen crash. Not the first crash, period, just the first on-screen crash. But yep, this is how the match ends. Not with a bang, but with a crash. With a bit of a yeah.
That's what I do. Like, just on Thursday when I was streaming, my game crashed. As I was hacking the cops.
Yeah, I would have normally redone the match, but you know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna report the problem and they will fix it for next time. Oh well, you know. Let's just go on with the show, with a part that will not crash, probably. Very dramatic final boss music for Tommy Wiseau. The most sacred of all matches, indeed.
Apparently, Jebusiah was so a big fan of the Dudleys.
Probably.
Because you can't have a Dudleys match without them getting at the tables for some goddamn reason.
I mean, yeah. But isn't the ring a table, as Tommy points out?
Surprised he didn't take the time to promote best friends while he was at it.
What a great promo by the legendary Tommy Wiseau. But first, our first title match of the evening, night, day. And we have our first potential episode title.
Yeah.
Courtesy of Crow, who refuses to humor Twitch by making an account. I mean, on one hand, I'm kind of glad that people believe in Adira, but did you see what Talvi did? Like, in general?
Yeah, that's why I'm betting on her.
And here she comes, spooky, scary skeletons. Ooh, right now we have an even split between... This rarely happens. Like a 50-50 split between the two. In terms of currency bent on them.
I mentioned how disappointing it is that there's no swimming pool rings in this game.
Yeah. Then again, this is a thing that kind of only happened in WCW as far as I know.
Yeah, but WWE don't owns WCW, so...
Yeah. Alright, the first ever Beach Party pay-per-view on the first season of LPFWA was the one where we ripped off the formation of the NWO, where Punchy and myself were taking the roles of Scott Hall and Kevin Nash, and Northern Lion was Hulk Hogan for some reason. Tolvi, of course, does not twerk. Because she can't wait to beat shit up.
Mm-hmm.
See, Fruity was there for it and he forgot about it because it was such a wet fart. But here we have wrestling. Oh my god.
There's an LPFWA wiki.
Yes, there is. I am omitting it for a reason. But there it is, it exists. I think Skier currently owns it or something? I don't know. It's not that anyone is even like updating it or anything, so. But this is how huge LPFWA once was, in a tiny forum called letsplayforum.net. Or org, I don't even know anymore. It's dead now. Rest in peace.
Let's Play Zone is where it's at now.
Ah, the legendary DDT6. Whoop, going for the pinfall early, and of course, one count.
Oh.
Yep, just the big power moves. Oh no, she's trying to make her humble.
Shit. Training for Toby, she's not Rusev.
I'm a standing moonsault because, of course. Oh, are you guys seeing the Deer Crescent already?
Maybe.
Nope! Nope! She's just teasing nothing in particular, I guess. Oh, an armbar. One of the legendary moves of Chris Jericho. Or like 100 of them.
He sure does have a lot of armbar.
I mean, to be fair, that's a lot of variations of the armbar.
Yeah. That's what Nagir gets for punching the air.
She's good at that.
Going outside.
Oh, she's doing the move. Ooh. Who would have thought that she would do a move? I mean, there is a tail match later on. Maybe Table Chan will be involved in that.
What's the count up to?
Six. You know, this seven. Is the part where we point out the championship's advantage and how Tolvi ignores it.
Yeah.
Just throwing her in and going for the pin. One. Very good. I can dig it. What's she doing? Okay. I thought it was gonna be like a superplex or something, but nah.
Nope, just repeated close to the turnbuckle.
She is
stretching.
Very exhausted from the looks of it. Might be the heat. Oh, do we get like a big move now? Oh, we get a big move now. Oh, it's the Muscle Buster.
Ooh. Can she get the pin?
She could have just done it without dragging her, but whatever. So, one, two. Ooh.
Oh.
Close. Yep, that's a finishing maneuver, clearly. I mean, in any other promotion, or rather in any other wrestling video game, I would say, yeah, this could be a 3 count. But this game just heavily favors finishers. Like, you know, WWE. And, well, most wrestling, actually. One.
Two.
Not even close. Just barely a 2. Ooh, reversal. Ooh. Oh, this could be it, though. Nope, just a frog splash. One, two, and two.
Ooh.
Ooh, she's going up again. The 450. Ooh, it was a weird one.
Very oddly angled 450. So oddly angled, it took the wind out of her sails.
Yep, don't go for the pin or anything, just yeah. I mean, it's not her finish anyway, but she's won with it before, so. Okay, this could be the Deer Crescent though, is it? It is.
Yes.
Okay. Let us see. One, two, three, and Nadira is the new Kawhi champion.
About that.
Well, she was denied the LPL Women's Champion twice, so. Well, actually, technically
twice.
Yeah, okay, I'm counting the match that didn't happen also. Okay, she
didn't happen was when we're Helena won.
Okay, yeah, both of them didn't happen. I don't know. It's something. It doesn't matter which one didn't happen. Because no one knows what happens anyway. It's all very confusing. She'll defend it 10 times and become the longest ranked Kawhi champion. Come on. Believe in her. Yeah, I've never seen your championship celebration because that part of music never played. Well, up next. Well, Fruit, you still have to bet all your coolness on yourself later on. Welp. Let's see who believes in DZB.
The Pokemon gimmick was the Pokemon's title, wasn't it?
Yep, it is currently held by an equipment crate.
Or is it?
We don't know, maybe it's changed hands back, I don't know. Here comes DZB. Shortest entrance ever.
Yeah. Pretty going all in on this one.
I mean, yeah. What he doesn't know is that his second bet will override the first. Mm. And, yep, starting immediately with the Canadian Space Murder. Program. Only it's not the Canadian Space Program, because first of all, she's Russian. Second of all, she's not D the Destroyer. Mm. Well, that's an interesting move.
Yeah.
Ooh, that was a sentient MGM out of nowhere, kind of. In a way. I think. Yep, DZB doing moves. She hasn't lost yet. Ooh, slapping her in the face. Throwing her around like it's nothing. Oh, she's going for the move. For one of them. Oh, different than I thought, but it's a move still.
Thought it was reversed for a minute there, but I guess not.
Ooh, yeah. One. Yeah, one.
DCB out of energy.
I mean, she usually doesn't crash that fast. Oh, she's going high again. She's just bringing all the moves today.
Sure is. Ooh. Taunting now?
I mean, why not? Oh, going up again. Is she gonna do the move she's gonna whiff now? Yes! She whiffed! I'm not happy she whiffed, it's just I find the move hilarious.
She grazed Lisa's head.
I think it does about equal damage to both. One. Aw. Ooh, it was a weird dropkick, but I like it. Yep, she's doing her thing now.
Just kicking the shit out of DCB.
Yep, going outside. This could be another DCB count out victory or loss. Two now. Oh god, just throwing her basically against the ring.
Yeah, stomping the shit out of her.
That's Elisaveta, as we know and love her. Ooh! She's kicking out almost immediately.
She's just gonna have to beat her up more.
I like how the commentators just all get up and panic, except Michael Cole just stays sitting down there.
He's seen it all before.
Yeah. Oh, this is a finisher. Like a generic German suplex. One, two, three. Yep, you wouldn't know that's a finisher if she didn't just completely die to it.
Yeah.
Easy B does not get her third win. Not today, anyway.
Like, yeah.
Like her third pinfall victory, that is, because, you know, she kind of had a lot of wins to just, you know, count outs, because I don't know, she's cursed.
Well, or that was just her strategy for a while.
To be fair, when I first got into wrestling games, that was also my strategy, because it's easy.
Yeah.
Then I stopped playing the games. And instead just did my wrestling EFAT stuff. Which is good because I don't have to play wrestling games anymore. Oh, the referee running away. Well, up next, unless I'm mistaken, we have the LP Superstar title match. Yep, I was right. Who would have thought? Let's see if Lore can break the streak. Which I think right now is one defense long.
One way to find out.
Well, as Loris Chester too will let you know, he was some champion once in some period of time, on some planet or dimension. I don't know. And it's towed with Hulk Hogan's WCW theme, because why not?
Why not?
As you can see, everybody that leaves in Lore Convoluter right now has 5 yes. points bet on him, whereas Toad has 20.
Yes, well, Lore didn't murder the previous champion.
I mean, yeah. But what if Lore now squashes Toad? Man, Fruity with the going all in. Wow, insane. He said something, probably something that was supposed to convolute the Lore.
Well, here's to face Toad none.
Toad exists currently. Very foreboding music. Probably a big match, you can tell because of the music. Oh man, look how epic that is. This is the music that's playing in Laura's head, by the way.
I can't actually hear it, so...
Wait, you can't?
No.
That's weird. But you should be hearing everything.
Alright, now I hear it.
Look at these moves happening, very impressive. Leg drop straight to... He was stealing his move, basically.
Yeah. Top rope something. Elbow. Top rope taunting.
Flexing to the crowd to let them know who's got the muscles, which is actually Toad. He's more buff.
Just someone grabbed him.
just basically, oh, you know, just casually throw you around a little bit. Have fun. Oh, Lore's making a comeback or something.
Ooh. He, I think. It's out.
I just realized that Lore and Toad both wear like the same color scheme.
Yeah. Fighting for that red, white, and blue.
Ooh! Not even the one count. Oh yeah, we're gonna see something good.
I broke something.
You know, ooh. Toad can technically break the ring with a superplex, so...
Ooh.
Oh, leg drop.
Leg drop.
Lore might be dead. One. Two.
Nope. Oh.
And the Rainmaker. And just slamming the damn head into the canvas. Oh, F you two. One count after frickin' finisher?
Lore is strong in this one.
I guess, yeah. Just no-selling the fucking...
Ooh.
Yeah. Arrow.
Stop to the back.
And ooh, the blood.
The blood. Is that when you believe that there's blood?
Yes, that is exactly what it means. Maybe I should have Bo Dallas in the match and make him bleed.
Maybe.
He did nothing wrong, though.
Ooh. Something. Ooh,
and
another leg drop.
Another leg drop, yep. This is the second one.
Stomp to the thigh, I guess.
Just for good measure.
Ooh.
Reversed, probably his signature move, because his sig is a corner clothesline. One of them anyway, he has several clotheslines. Oh, going up, not quite, okay.
Ooh. Just slamming his face into the turnbuckle.
One, two,
ah. Punching each other now.
Because why not, you know? It's gotta happen in every match at one point. Good old strike exchange.
He's all tuckered out from the punching.
Oh, he's going for the FU2 again.
Can he get it?
Oh, he's reversing
no.
it.
Ooh.
Oh, he's he had two finishes stored. Welp. One, two. No. That's the second finish you get out of. Not a one count this time, though. I was the second finisher, though. Like, the second got reversed.
Yeah.
Oh, he's going for the super kick.
Oh, but he Missed, sort of, I think.
Yeah, that was a whiff. Which, well, it was a reversal, kind of. Which means that Toad now has a finisher again. Which could be the third FU2. Oh, wow. He's doing stuff.
Ooh. Some sort of head scissors thing.
What the fuck? What the hell was
that? That was.
It was good. I didn't know what it was, but it was good. Oh, there we go. The third FU2. Still only a 2 count. You know, Roman Reigns took like 5 of those, or 6, I don't know anymore. Oh, technically it was an F5, but whatever.
The lore can just not be straightened out. Nope. Oh.
Headbutt.
Oh. Oh. Neckbreaker.
Just violence now. I mean, Toad sure likes that move this match. I haven't seen them do it before, I don't think.
One, two.
Oh, super kick. There we go. This could be a 1 count.
Could be.
One, two.
Nah. What was the 2 count?
Anto's leg is vibrating.
That was Lord's first pin attempt in this match.
It was, yeah. It was also his first finisher, as opposed to 3 he took already, and the 2 leg drops. Oh, that's his another signature, though.
Running blue lines.
Chops to the shoulders.
This really is a WrestleMania main event at this point. Only the last 10 the last few sucked royally, and well, let's say the most recent WrestleMania had an offensively bad one.
Yeah.
They were, we want Nicholas chance, and this is awful chance.
And beach balls.
And beach balls. And we want beach ball chance, yeah. And we're at a beach party. And you know, the crowd is invested, there's no beach balls. Because this is actually a good match, as opposed to whatever it is that WWE was doing at WrestleMania.
It's dishing out all kinds of punishment, and Lore's just taking it.
And eventually, one of them has to, you know.
One, two.
Straight in the mushroom. Oh, another super kick. And this time it connects. Like, the weird one, you know. That's the second one that connects, actually. Ooh, and almost sealed the deal there.
Or a top rope something. Or Brett's rope something.
Some rope something.
Axe handle. Alright.
Oh, yeah. This is number four. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
And about time.
Finally.
And Toad is basically dead.
Yeah, he had to work hard to win this one.
Oh, yeah. I'm not sure what this says about lore, though.
That he's tough?
Maybe? Maybe, yeah, maybe he's tough. Like, he's been involved in, like, a lot of good matches. It's just he, I'd say he's more of a workhorse than anything. Probably. And he is American-made.
Sure it is.
And yep, up next we have the Palpatine Dream versus Fruity.
Alright.
Oh, but first, something's happening.
Oh?
Oh, it's just Chef Life interviewing the Palpster.
By hugging.
Yes, kind of.
Oh, he gets everything. We'll see about that.
But Fruity has explored the dark side of hugging.
Well, as long as he murders them gently.
Yeah, so it's more painful. Yeah. Well, it is now time for Fruity to go all in.
Oh. In this match of Palpine versus Fruity.
Yep, Palpine. That is definitely what he's called. Everyone's betting on Fruity. Well, I will play house, is the thing, so. If it's one-sided, I'll just, do my thing. Holy shit, he actually's doing it. Now I have to counter that. Fruit, you did it wrong again. You bet on option 1,700. There is no option 1,700. You're bad at this, I'm sorry. Okay, so here we go. Evening of the odds, more or less.
Yeah.
Wait, how much coolness do I have?
A lot.
Yeah.
Like, not that much.
I have, like, you have to add the amount that just bet, because that's in the pool right now. But yeah, the legendary Palpatine is doing stuff to make the Bunny Championship great again. Maybe at some point, Fruity needs a championship entrance. A really big, bombastic one. Also, maybe I need subtitles for a song. Then again, it's not
hurt.
It's not good enough for subtitles, come on. It's just a song about hugging. Look at that beauty of a title.
It is glorious. I don't know what signs and a marry me sign.
And then maybe sign in the background. There's plenty of signs, and all of them are bad.
Rudy has embraced the power of the dark side. He's ready to fight.
Nice twirl. Of course Palpy starts because he's the guy who made that title great. And oh, by the way, this is a hardcore match, so I forgot to tell. Sledgehammer immediately.
Ooh.
It's time for some hardcore hugging.
Cutting.
This, of course, also means there's no countout because I hate when that happens.
Yeah, I can imagine. But they're back in the ring now anyway.
And they could do what they want outside. They could just even go into the crowd pits. Oh, there is no crowd pits. Okay, whatever. Yeah, I was, some attempts at moves.
Who's taking over, sign guy? Apparently you have an invasion on your hands, Iggy.
Yeah, whatever.
With some random audience members.
I mean, we had the invasion angle before and it sucked, so maybe if we get a real shoot invasion, that would be cool.
Maybe you can get some other internet fed to invade LPFWA.
Well, are there any?
Invade them.
Are there any?
I'm sure
that,
there are.
That are in the right spirit for this. Do any of them have a Huckster versus Palpatine? Because most I've seen kind of take themselves more seriously or are VGCW. I think Palpy's confused.
If I were to run a REST internet ethed, mine would probably be close to this. Unfortunately, that would require me to own this game, and I don't want to do that.
Unfortunately, this would also require you to actually use this game's editor and stuff, so... It's probably for the better. Because I would not recommend this, it's just I do this for reasons that are beyond even myself, and oh, this is the setup for Hug Life. Oh,
oh man.
Willie pats him on the back.
Feel the love, Palpy. Feel it.
He does! He does pat him on the back!
I don't want to embrace the light side.
Fruity won and wins a shit ton of coolness. Motherfucker. And I lose it all. Except, I can just give myself a million coolness. You know what?
I suppose you could.
Let's just do it.
Wouldn't need to worry about having to add more money to yourself after that.
I could have given myself even more than that, but you know. I could also remove it again from myself. You know, I don't want to be remembered as a filthy cheater, so there we go. Yep, Hug Life reigns supreme. Just a few episodes ago, Fruity was doubting his abilities. He thought he couldn't hug anymore. He didn't have what it takes, but now he's back and he's like just hugging people left and right. But there's one more thing he needs to do. He needs to hug the guy who hugged him. I think it was Flamander? It was Flamander, right? Yeah, it was Flamander. It has to be Flamander.
Someone we haven't seen in a while, actually.
Yeah. After a thing he did, I forget. I think it'll... Did he have a champion? No, he didn't. Man, this is confusing. I don't remember the lore of my own show anymore.
What was the question?
It doesn't matter. Because I don't know the answer, and I'm the only one who could know it. Welp, that was match number 5, and next up... We should have the COCOM title match. Maybe the Hyrule Warriors can reign supreme today if they can defend their tag team titles as well. This is of course a Hell in a Cell match. I think I forgot to point that out. So it's at the same time also a tornado tag match. I don't think we've had a title defense yet that was tornado, right? Maybe I'm wrong. Because we've had a tornado match a couple days back, but it wasn't a title match, I think. I could be wrong. I'm probably wrong. You
back just in time for the other power, Dark Side.
Yeah, and of course, since this is a beach party, Kylo will show off his hot bod once more.
Oh. But will Face?
Nah. Face is real hardcore. He wears his like full-on riot gear, which has to be really, really, really hot. Because,
I mean, you can take the vest and the jacket off and just leave everything else on.
He could, but, you know.
Getting the hot bod spirit.
The hot bod spirit. yes. Let me play house.
Will be a clean sweep tonight for the Hagru Warriors.
And yeah, they would all have a title except for Lotus, who is not officially a member yet, but he will join them shortly. Ah.
Well, to be fair, no one won that match.
Oh yeah, Kyle's hot bod. Think of it, why did Palpy show his hot bod today? Maybe he wasn't at full power, maybe that's why he lost. Maybe he let Fruity win, maybe this is all... I don't know.
He's getting too in touch with the light side of the Force.
Hello, DZB. You've missed a few really good matches.
And you lost.
And
again.
Yeah. I'm sorry you had to learn this way.
Well, that's me. Death, bringer of bad news. Always.
Interesting move from Katira there.
Bad news that this is a Hell in a Cell match, and that probably won't matter at all.
I mean, it matters in the sense that it's Tornado rules, so... One of these days, maybe the cell will get, like, destroyed and... Yeah, that's why I'm having these matches. I just want it to happen eventually.
Yeah.
It has to happen for the end of the show, because, like, not this show, just the end of LPAA in general, because I just want it to happen.
Oh, taking the thing off the turnbuckle.
They should take the walls of the cell instead of that. Come on.
Yeah. Can you do War Games matches in this game?
Nah. That would be cool, though.
Yeah.
Ooh, just decapitating Kylo Ren.
Well, the next one then, since I just did War Games for one of the NXTs.
Yeah, but maybe they'll be in the next game. I don't know, because the match was really good.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Also, War Games is good. Except when TNA does it. Then it's Lethal Lockdown. And that's all that needs to be said about that.
And I gotta say, the idea of having two rings in a match at the same time sounds really dumb otherwise, but War Games rules.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it gives you more space to work with. I'm not worried about 10 guys all trying to do stuff in one ring.
And dropkick to Kylo's face. As the turnbuckle goes to Link's face.
Should you do that on the turnbuckle he exposed, not like that one?
Yeah, but you know, it was farther away. Oh, Link is doing something. Fist to face's face, wow.
Ooh.
No, everybody's had their face damaged somehow.
Ooh.
Ooh. One. You know, every time they go outside, I think maybe they will go to that right wall, to the bottom part that can be knocked off, but they never do.
Hope.
Yeah. And Rainmaker!
Nice. A transitional move.
It is a transitional move. Much like this bottle of wine I'm drinking, it's just a transitional drink. Oh, Hangman CDT.
Ooh. Is he going to pin him?
He was going to go for it, but...
Oh, no. The two standing men decided they had to fight.
I mean, let's be fair here. Katia Lecce would have interrupted it, probably.
Probably. Or he just would have been not interested and gone after Kylo's hot bod some more. Okay.
That was an interesting, thing. Oh, Kylo's going for something. Starkiller.
Ooh. Oh, what the pin.
Immediately broken up because, of course.
Ooh. Okay. One.
Yep. Yep, this makes sense.
Nice punch to the rope, Link.
Shouldn't crack me up like this, but it does. Ooh, the ref kind of...
Almost died.
Yeah.
Hang on. I lost up to something. Oh, just the top rope elbow. To the head. Oh.
One. Two.
Ah. Oh.
One.
Nope, that's not how it works. Yet. Was quite the suplex. It somehow looked more powerful than Yelizaveta's, who has the German suplex as her finisher.
Ooh. Oh.
Ooh. One, two.
Ah. It appears to be annoyed.
Oh, okay. Two of the world head scissor thingamajig.
Yes, from the known luchador.
Face is bleeding.
Now Kylo's beating the shit out of Link for it.
Well, legendary that wasn't DDT6, I think.
One. Oh.
Oh, Sling Blade.
No.
Star Killer.
Oh. Jerry got to know that.
One.
Oh, he's going for the. Oh, he was going for his clothesline from hell, but now. Oh, there it is.
Oh. I need to take a break first. And get punished by Kylo for it.
Oh yeah.
One.
Two. Aww. Too bad.
Ooh.
I mean, you can tell who I'm rooting for, I think.
Like how Face hit the move, and then nothing happened, and then Blink belatedly sold for it.
Ooh, I thought it was gonna be a jackknife, but instead it's a roll-up. Oh. Oh yeah. No.
Oh. Famous luchador power and busting out another tilt throw.
And he does have the force on his side, so it's very acrobatic, because, you know.
Oh.
Katira has some kind of plan. I see.
Yeah. Slash his ass.
Freaking chokeslam to Link!
And me too. Katira's face, which now Face will capitalize on, I guess. Why not?
And another Sling Blade to Face. Meanwhile, I think Kyle's going for another Starkiller. He is!
Yep. Somehow didn't knock over Face and Terry when he did it.
One, two, three. Oh, and Face just pushing Katira down. Rude as fuck. But yep, that's it. The first aura actually won.
Yeah.
Rest in peace, Hargul Warriors. Until you come back, of course, which, given that there's so few tag teams, is probably gonna be soon.
Yeah.
But we have more teams than in the previous LBWA, so that's good.
Yeah. I suppose Link is the weakest Link. Are celebrating with their new titles. Have they held those before?
Yep, they have. This exact team. Only they were called the Aura 66 at the time, were accompanied by Palpatine.
Yeah. Well, till next time. Maybe we'll get to see Face's hot bod someday.
Perhaps.
Maybe
who knows?
We'll get to see someone going through the cage someday, Iggy.
Maybe. Maybe. Yes. It could happen anytime. Oh, and here we go. This is a big grudge match.
If your fighting mate match with Al ever happens, you can always make it Hell in a Cell.
Here comes Angus. Different music this time because, well, he requested it.
Because also copyright issues was my understanding.
Well, he requested a song before that.
Yes. Well, in hindsight, it was fortunate not him to request it.
Yep.
The second greatest scope man in all of LPFWA.
This is, of course, a 15-minute tables Iron Man match, which means tables will die multiple times. The Tommy promised to show his divine form to us.
Ah,
there he is. How divine.
Why?
Because.
Why have you done this to us?
Because I can. Who can bet against Tommy Wise so well?
Everyone. It's the power of coolness to make him lose.
I'm gonna bet against Tommy just because I can. I mean, Angus will kill me probably because he's against me for some reason, but still. And there goes a transitional song.
Mage's version of the song?
No, it's actually the Advent Children version of the song.
Which for sure was done by Black Mages.
I mean, I don't think that Black Mages did One Winged Angel. I know they did Dancing Mad, but look, they did three albums, right? Not four.
Let's have a look.
Maybe they did, I don't know.
Yep, they've got One Winged Angel.
Oh, they did? Okay, good. Well, this isn't the One Winged Angel, the Black Mages version. This is the Advent Children version. Still a transitional song.
Oh, here comes the table.
The first of hopefully many. And alright, I forgot to put like a scoreboard in the video, so we have to keep count ourselves. But that just makes it more interesting because you have to actually watch the match. Oh, I think this is the first table. That's one for Angus. After only a bit more than 2 minutes. My wine is empty. Just an FYI.
Oh dear. What a horrible time to run out of that.
You're right, it's comedy, horrible so. That it would run out of wine now. lacking pants for Action Wood Angus. That is actually good enough. But I'm not sure, can it beat Crows from earlier? Oh. Just, you know, Crow just posts his in the Discord because he's a weirdo. This is what he posted after the game crashed.
Yeah, I saw.
It was good. Oh man, I just think I have to roll a dice in those. Or maybe something even better comes up, who knows? Actually, I always want to have lacking pants, like the combination of words in one of my video titles.
There.
Oh, I think he has a problem. I think this corner might be cursed. Yep, that's right, Tommy. Go to a different... Yep, okay, that one works. Good.
Yes.
That other one clearly was cursed.
There's my title contribution for the week.
Nice
try. My reaction
to
seeing Tommy Wiseau.
Nice try.
My reaction to seeing Tommy Wiseau.
Come on, not that bad. Like, Tommy can just present himself any way he likes.
That's true.
Oh, I have to just copy-paste all these into my spreadsheet now. Text file. I don't have a spreadsheet for these yet.
Table did not break. It still did not break. Ooh.
Chops usually don't break tables, but...
Come now, Angus. Oh, what's he doing?
He's realigning the table to a different corner?
Okay. Sure. Oh, the table still is not broken.
Another good one, actually. Yeah, I have to copy-paste all of these to my text file, and eventually I will have to put them in a spreadsheet and write an algorithm to... Oh, there you go. This is 2-0, right?
Yes. Don't worry, I'm keeping score.
I'm also keeping score in my heart.
I'm keeping score in chat.
Okay, that table. That table made an exit. Oh man. I am a bit sad.
Well, that just means they won't find a winner then, Zephyr.
Yeah, I'm a bit sad though that there can't be like multiple like broken tables in the ring at the same time.
Yeah. I can't handle the physics.
I mean, considering what happened the first match, which crashed the game, yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh.
No one ever breaks the table that way, come on. I mean, they could theoretically do it, but never do. Oh, do they? Oh no, they don't. Come on, it was a reversal. Aww. Come on.
Well, there's no I am the table chance, so.
I need to add those, but I have added this one. Why did it do this? That's a good question. Oh my god!
Oh, fuck.
2-1. The next table spawns right there. Tommy ignores it and goes for a different table. Oh, okay. Oh. Whatever.
If he had like actually just like stepped on it, flipped it up into his hands, that would have been cool.
If he just broken the table accidentally over himself. Oh, another corner table. Oh, he's going through, I think. Yep! That is 2-2. Oh, Table Chan is getting her covers removed. Whoa. How lewd.
Man. I think I'm sending him through the Spanish announce table.
Will this actually happen? Well, there isn't. Well, okay. It is a Spanish announce table.
They're not there.
But there's no Spanish commentary team.
Or I guess, suppose, technically, that's supposed to be us since it's two tables, but we're not there.
It could also be the German announces table. I don't know. That's pretty common these days.
Yes, we're invisible right now.
I could switch my commentary to German. Should I?
I would understand very basic words and nothing else.
Oh nein, Tommy geht in die verfluchte Ecke. Oh, stellt den Tisch auf. That was all I got.
Yeah. Oats agree.
This is a table, yeah? That's German.
Yes.
Oh, the table is positioned? Could this shitty fucking move through a fucking table? Oh no, it's not a shitty, it's a,
What?
This is good! I can't believe that Tommy just did a move that wasn't shitty through a table. But now he has a chair somehow. I don't know. What's happening?
That damn fool bringing it,
Tommy,
bringing a chair to a tables match.
What are you doing, table? No! Tommy!
He broke.
Stop, Tommy.
He did something not shitty and so he can't handle it.
Yeah, I think he's broken. He's dead. But he's in the lead, so it doesn't matter. Okay.
Oh, fuck. Well, now I guess it's broken.
He was trying to lull it in a false sense of security. I think, oh yeah, Tommy's broken! Oh,
or not.
This is good stuff. They can't lie. And boom!
Oh!
And, oh, is, what's he gonna do now? Is he gonna do it again? Is he gonna? Oh, he's doing it again! This is the Four Corner Massacre! Okay, this is the third. He reversed it. Oh, no, he did not. Fuck. Can we have the fourth side of the ring?
No, Angus is too close to it.
Oh, he's a fucking heel. He's not doing it. What a piece of shit. That would have been so good, though. Oh, man. Oh, I wouldn't have been mad about that. Maybe Tommy realized to truly cement his victory, he needs to put Tommy through another table. I mean, Angus from another table.
Tommy's gonna put through Tommy a table.
Tommy table.
Oh no! Oh!
They can't go through that, by the way. Like, if it's propped up like that.
Ah, not close enough.
Putting it away from the cursed corner into the non-cursed corner, the opposite corner.
Or Angus is gassed.
Oh, this is,
Four.
2 minutes for Angus to, you know, do his work. The chair is still somehow in the tables match.
God damn it, Angus. Put him through a table.
Oh, on the chair? Okay, never mind. Nope. That would have been vicious. Is Tommy doing it? He is, I think. Four. He has 1 minute left.
Well, he has to get two more to win.
But he could tie it. That would be something at least.
The announcer save on the outside. Or not.
I mean, he could do that, but he is probably on a lot of whiskey.
Oh.
He's taunting! I mean, to be fair, the performers don't know how much time is left. So, yeah.
Well,
oh, table is... Oh, no, never mind. Tommy Wiseau wins the grudge match.
Oh, man. I was going to be in for an unpleasant surprise later.
What a dark day for people, not Tommy Wiseau. I bet against Tommy. Holy shit, I'm so stupid. And I knew who was going to win beforehand. That's the worst part. Congrats, DZB.
So Angelico is too powerful.
Yep, but next time we meet him, he will be back to his normal theme song.
Yes.
Which will be horrible.
Yes. Next time he needs a super appearance, he should just go with Samurai Cop 2.
Oh, this match, right. Lotus versus Shane O'Mac.
No, no DCB. Someone did not have to believe in him.
It's true, Tommy is the underdog, though. He gets an unfair rap because he made the shitty movie once, or several, but...
He made multiple shitty movies.
Yeah, but does it make him any worse of a person?
Well... No?
Like, are the movies offensive or just offensively bad? That's the question here. I mean, no, they're offensively bad, but... As far as I know, he didn't actually do anything that... I don't know... would make him horrible. I think.
Yeah.
Still, I can't believe it booked Tommy as the fucking face in this feud. What's wrong with me? I should root for the Scotsman, obviously.
This is clearly going to be the battle of who has the shittiest punches.
Will we see the shitty Shane punches, though? That's a real question. I think they're his signature move.
Of course they are.
Yeah. But yep, here comes the money. Everybody betting on Lotus here. So I will have to
play. This goober to win.
I mean, Shane McMahon is kind of cool. He's been involved in some of the... Not
no,
the
he's
best.
Not.
He was in the match with Kurt Angle once, where he went through plexiglass, and it was not gimmicked.
Yes.
And he was
and he
very
jumped
hard.
Off Hell in a Cell.
Oh yeah, he did that. He also jumped off of the scaffolding, like, at the entrance.
Yeah.
Basically, Shane also sold the helicopter crash as well.
Yeah.
So there we go.
Yes, and I suppose he's the nice McMahon. That's about all he's got going for him.
He's the nicer of the two. Oh, he dabbed immediately. Perfect.
Of course.
Shane McMahon completely no-selling the dab. That guy's meme game is not exactly on the level. Okay, this is also a hardcore match because there are extreme rules and
yeah.
There's more of a chance of Shane McMahon jumping off tall things when he doesn't have any rules to follow.
There's not exactly a whole bunch of tall things for him to jump off of in this arena.
I mean, maybe a rope will descend from the top of the arena and he can climb up on like the like stuff that's up there and jump down and miss and still win somehow by I can't believe that in his match against the Undertaker actually sold Shane's submission. I was fucking dumb.
Well, like, I believe Undertaker could quit right after that until like he changed his mind and came back next year.
I mean, he always does that though.
Yeah.
He essentially wrestles at WrestleMania these days.
I suppose Shane can find something a huge jump off of, miss, and make his diverticulitis worse.
Well, yeah, see, the thing is also Shane gets older and older, so the next time he jumps off something tall, the chance is that he might break something. But he also knows so the actual helicopter crash, so I don't think he's in any trouble yet. But of course, I am rooting for my buddy Lotus.
I think we're all rooting for him.
I mean, yeah. But Shane McMahon was cool when he chopped off tall things, right?
Sure.
It's just he usually loses when he does it. Because he's not actually a wrestler, he's just a guy who exists and does stupid things.
Nah.
And he knows the helicopter crash.
So you keep saying.
He did that though, that's why I'm saying it. Like it's not a work, he did that actually.
So it was a shoot helicopter crash.
A shoot helicopter crash indeed. And now actually that wasn't work, DDT, whatever.
I guess. Shoot helicopter crash followed by him going to shoot hospital.
Oops, that was DDT.
Oh. What's happening?
He's trying to get something.
Oh, he's getting a thing.
A thing, yes. A baseball bat.
Oh, a bat.
This is like when Sting showed up that
Lotus
one time. Ooh.
Yes. Did the... okay.
Oh, it was almost a pinfall victory for a baseball bat over Shane McMahon. Like the one time we had a pinfall victory of a sledgehammer over Triple H. Oh, Imploder 450,
ooh.
His finisher.
Can we get the pin?
One.
Win.
Two.
Two.
Ooh.
Ah. Get the bat. Beat the shit out of him, Lotus.
Lotus a face, though.
Do Sting proud.
The Shane O'Mac shuffle!
Fucking nerd.
Are you complaining? Because the Shane O'Mac shuffle is good. I must see. Oh, shitty Shane punches! Shitty Shane punches!
No.
Oh no, he's doing it! Those were some shitty fucking punches. The referee can't believe it. The baseball bat can neither.
Oh my god. I was going for something else.
Now he's... Oh, a ladder? Ladders. What the hell? This is never gonna go anywhere.
Oh, now Shane has something high to jump off of.
Yep, that's how you jump off of things. You could stack multiple ladders like a house of cards.
What is happening right
now? Oh, he's doing that again! Yeah! Nice. I'm glad that Lotus can dab. Maybe the next match, like the next whatever match it will be, will have some stipulation there that he'll vote on as well. That seems a good idea.
Ooh. Oh no, he's gonna do it on the barricade. Nope.
Can Shane do power bombs in real life?
Probably not anymore.
Like, this is old Shane in the game right now. Yeah. You can see he has gray hair.
Yes. Oh.
Oh god, no, this is a submission.
But Lotus is turning into a clam.
It's true, like, I like Shane mostly for doing really stupid stuff, but I also hope he doesn't die because of doing really stupid stuff. Which, at his age, is increasingly more likely that he will, I don't know, just die randomly from jumping off of a very, very tall thing.
Well, again, he has diverticulitis now. A Brock Lesnar disease. Oh, okay. That was a weird sell.
A very weird sell, yeah. They're going to the crowd. Never mind.
Oh,
they're
nope.
Going back in.
Okay.
Because when they're going out, they never go back in. Except this time, of course. Oh, onto the stairs!
Oh, on the stairs. Sort of.
Yeah. Oh, another time? Nope. Nope. Just onto the barricade. Oh my god! What the fuck? I think Shane just broke his leg several times. Stumbling over a ladder. Very nice. Exactly what I'm here for.
Ooh.
And back, going back in the baseball bat, still just kind of sitting there, waiting. Oh no, shitty Shane punches,
no.
He's doing it!
No.
Those are shitty fucking punches, holy shit! One.
Two.
This is his most...
You should give Tommy Wiseau that move.
This is... He has that move.
Oh, he does?
He does. Oh no, the triangle hold.
Again. You're next to ropes, dude. Just grab them. Oh, wait, no, it's DQ. No, DQ. Never
yep,
mind.
Yep, there's no rope break here. Oh. Man, what's Shane doing here? Something,
Something high?
Something where he does... Yeah. I didn't know he could actually do moves that... are supposed to damage the opponent from that height.
Well, it looks like it hurt him too, so...
Of course it did.
Apparently he can't.
I mean, yeah. One,
two.
Nope. Oh. Lotus will not give up that easily. Nice arrest hold. Understandable at Shane's age.
Yes. Maybe she didn't do him sooner.
Honestly, this match has been going on for a few minutes now, so I think it would be understandable to do something that is not that physical.
After this match, I really hope Lotus does get into the Hug of the Warriors. Cersei after having to be put through this.
I mean, he will be in Hyrule Warriors. Yeah. Because he's Lotus.
Grab the mat.
But Lotus is a face, he wouldn't do that. He'll just do the fucking move onto the bat! This is a signature move!
Stomp his face. Knee him in the head.
He's just looking at him.
Watch him as he staggered.
Looking at Shane McMahon.
After Lotus, that's how DCB lost her title.
It is. Wait, DCB had a title once?
Pokemons, remember?
Alright, yeah.
Yes,
the one that is currently currently held by a crate.
Maybe.
Probably. Onto a bat, holy shit. Looking at him again. Admiring his whatever it is, I don't know. His sick cell of some movie did. I think Lotus wants him to win.
No.
Oh, the legendary DDT6.
God damn it.
What's up with Lotus?
And immediately Shane just goes on the offensive from that too, so it's like, what the hell?
Just standing there!
Stop it.
Lotus would have had this by now if he'd actually...
One, two.
What would you do if Shane won with the shitty Shane punches?
I'd demand a refund.
you didn't pay anything.
I paid coolness.
Yeah, but good luck getting that back.
Oh, now Shane's gotta take a break.
He's like 40 or something, right? Nearing 50?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
That's happening though.
I mean, I'd say Lotus beat him up pretty good, it's just he doesn't follow through.
Shane McMahon is 48 years old.
Alright. It's the move again.
Come on.
Fucking bullshit. Come on. Well, there we go. Jackknife powerbomb.
In the hold.
Triangle hold. And he taps! That's of course he does. Here comes the money. Well, we did see the Imploder 450 at least. And the shitty Shane punches. So
you know, you're right. I agree with DCB. I would vote for someone to kick his ass next week. Probably do, man. That's what I always hope for.
Yeah. I wonder. Oh, that's horrible. Well.
Speaking of Goldberg.
Speaking of Goldberg, yes, I was about to say. Goldberg versus Nufkins for the LPFWA title. There can be no peace on earth without
pro wrestling. And the crowd's already chanting Goldberg, I don't need to do it for them.
Goldberg leaving his joint practice he shares with Dr. Ham.
Yeah, Dr. Ham is not accompanying him today because this is a big match. And Goldberg wants to do it on his own because he's technically a face.
It's Dr. Ham's busy fit cleaning up after all the murders that happened today on the show.
Yeah.
With Angus. Who else got killed?
Nuffkins. No, I should. Like, if I had, like, custom chants like these. But, yeah. You know, I'd have to get people to actually chant Nuffkins and get enough people to do that.
That's hard. Just ask a bunch of people to record Audacity clips for you and just throw them all together.
But from experience, that doesn't sound very good. I'd need an actual crowd to do it. And yeah, good luck finding a crowd to chant Nuffkins. Just at that, I could probably get Blind Sally to do that. Just saying, we want pizza. Five claps as a singular person. Because there was like a chant in WWE 2K14, which is a single guy yelling, this is awesome. I don't know why they did this. Just single guy. There was no group chant in that game for this is awesome. Just a single, solitary guy yelling in a kind of really rough voice, this is awesome. That happened, that's real. And yep, this will be Nuffkins' sixth defense, I think. Provided
this belt is bigger, the belt is not big enough for him.
Nope, it is not. But yeah, since apparently no one in LWA can beat Nuffkins, Goldberg decided to show up.
Well, at least there's a whole bunch of people he hasn't challenged yet.
I mean, yeah, maybe he will have, like, gone through them all by the end of the show. I don't know. could happen. Well, the bets are split 40% for Goldberg, 60% for Nuffkins. They both have the same stat overall, but I'm gonna tell you something. I did a match Nuffkins versus Goldberg where I controlled Nuffkins, and I could swear that Goldberg is favored by the game somehow, because he kicked out of everything.
Well, Freddy, Nuffkins still doesn't have anything on his torso other than a vest, so
Freddy's
more clothing he could get.
Yeah, also, Nuffkins already stole gimmicks. Remember when he was the Nuffster? Or when he was Stone Cold Nuffkins? Because both of those things happened. Like, the point of this gimmick is that he's, like, building his own outfit out of something. I don't know. Out of other outfits.
Random stuff. He needs to find someone with a good shirt or a hot bod and challenge them.
Yeah, I don't think he can wear anything more because there's no points left in Nuffkin's outfit. Otherwise, I would have like given him sunglasses or something he could steal from someone. I don't know. But he looks shitty enough as is, so everything's fine.
Well, according to you, he's supposed to be a dinosaur, so...
I mean... Technically, because Nuffkins'
Avatar is a dinosaur, like a shitty dinosaur, but a dinosaur nonetheless. That's the entire reasoning behind it. Also, Nufkin says he's a dinosaur, so that's why.
Oh, that'll do it.
It would be sick if Nufkin threw springboard moves.
He's too big.
You say that, but it doesn't prevent the game from letting you do springboard moves.
What's he doing?
Just throwing Goldberg to the corner, because why not? Classic Nufkins.
Ooh.
In a real Goldberg match would already be over.
Yeah. This is early 2000s Goldberg.
It actually is. I actually think it's like 98 Goldberg, I don't know. Like, who would have thunk? Like, it's not like Goldberg did any moves yet. Taunting, getting punished.
Ooh. Stomped nothing.
Yep. Oh, Nufkin's move. Can he follow with the other Nufkin's move? Yes, he can. Both Nufkin's moves have connected. One, two.
Ooh.
Ah. Not yet. Perhaps not ever. Again, this match could technically end by the ring breaking. I feel the need to point that out whenever they go to the corner.
Well, not this time.
Nope.
Oh.
Goldberg actually doing some kind of moves. Aside from his two usual moves.
Stomping the knees.
That's already much more technical than the average Goldberg match.
Oh yeah.
And you didn't really do a lot yet. Of course Nufkin's fighting out of it.
Yeah.
Two. Nope. Just two.
So what happens if Goldberg wins?
Well, then he has the title and has to defend it next month.
Oh.
Because you know, this is not like actual WWE or something where Goldberg is only hired for like a few months for one match. I could just use his character forever if you like it.
Mm.
Oh, Nufkin's move again. Like, Nufkin has multiple moves that he does as finishers. I don't know which are signatures and which are finishers only. That's the thing. Oh, is this the jackhammer? It is!
Yeah.
Ooh.
One.
When.
Two.
Ah. So close. Doing something. He's going to go for the spear.
Yep.
Nope. Oh, he's going to get punched.
And the Nufkin's move.
One, two.
No, oh. That was close though.
Oh, stops like this.
I think Twitch briefly disconnected for some reason, but I should be back now.
It did freeze, but like I still saw the screen share.
Yeah, I know, because I didn't lose connection. Anyway, Goldberg's going for the pin. One count. Yeah, Kevin Dunn fucked up in the production truck. Actually, I don't employ him, so whatever.
Well, he fucked up in the production truck anyway.
He did. Like, not in ours, just in any production truck.
Yeah. What's this? Oh.
It's some STF choke slam thing. Oh, he's going for the spear, I think.
He's throwing a spear.
There we go.
Whoop. Got him. I'll pin him. One, two, oh.
Oh, another jackhammer. Can't wait.
Can't get it.
You know, when Goldberg's first run was, you know, happening, I thought he was really cool because he beat everybody up.
Yeah. One, two.
Ooh, that was actually close.
Damn. Nope. Put him over the shoulder.
Nufkin's move. Ah yes, the time of the match where the rest holds begin. One, two.
Oh yeah, I guess chat's apparently not showing up on screen.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. I don't think I can fix that though. Because that's your problem with Streamlabs. One, two.
Two.
Chat works again now, let's see. No it doesn't. Well, whatever. Chat is dead now. We should pretend it's really active. Come on. That was rude. 2-3. I'm glad we had Botchamania chance immediately before Nufkins won.
Well, gonna have to find someone else to fight now.
Yeah. He does.
Yes.
I'm not gonna let Nufkins fight Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar isn't good enough.
Yes. Well, you could always fight Palpatine.
Maybe.
Fight you. Fight Goatman. Fight Sheer. He's been missing a while. As you said. A whole bunch of people he hasn't fought yet. I suppose you could also just make one of the creative characters you have on your list still have them fight him.
I'll just have a big gauntlet match, which isn't supported by the game, where he has to fight everybody at the same time. Okay, the only match left on the card is Valerie Easton versus Helena.
Such a cute couple.
Yeah. I had to smile this entire time, because it's so nice. So, those two have fought twice before. Both times, Val won. And apparently,
well, she is.
Everybody thinks she will again.
Yeah. She's the favorite tonight.
Well, screw y'all. I'm gonna bet for Helena. Mainly to play house, but I will.
Now you gotta bet house some more.
Whatever. I'm gonna just not do that. This is good enough. I did my job. And it just turned night, by the way.
Yeah.
Val actually summoned an eclipse. Because she's a witch. She can do that.
Oh yeah. I was wondering about that. Didn't notice it was getting progressively darker as the show went on.
Well, it's the technical day, it's just that it's night now for reasons that are only related due to these two people being like beings of darkness or something. Wait, chat is back? Chat is actually back. Holy shit.
Wow. And they threw some dark magic your way and fixed chat.
Actually, yeah.
The belt matches her outfit.
Yep, it does. Thank you. I could have given people more time to place their bets because this entrance will take a while, but I did not. It's okay. Chat is back.
Is just standing in the ring, looking like she's just waiting for it to be over.
And she's smiling. She's just happy that her girlfriend's coming to the ring, posing around a little bit. There was a WWE Rock sign in the background. I will have to throw that guy out.
Set his sign on fire.
Full disclosure, I've used that arena type before and set it to night, so it seems like an indoors arena. But, you know. No one noticed. Thankfully, because technically we can't be outside on the moon without probably dying.
Well, you couldn't. I could.
Yeah, okay. Helena not twerking, of course. Several high mom signs in the background.
Man, all these high moms.
Yeah. 420. Alright, let's see what happens.
What happens is Helena starts us off strong. Starts freaking out.
And she just had to beat up her girlfriend, so that's understandable. She doesn't really understand these emotions yet. But hey, I think she got over it already.
Yeah. It is a match after all. So choose between her title and her girlfriend.
That was a sick big boot or something.
Yeah, that apparently hurt her too.
Well, DZB, this match technically was supposed to happen last week. And it wasn't Pride Month then. Technically.
Well, it's Pride Month now,
so... We can extend our Pride Month to 1 week after, whatever this month is. June? We have June, right?
Yes, June.
Yeah, the first week of July would still be Pride Month. Will I have a show then? I don't know. Oh yeah, I will. Because it's not the 4th of July or something where I have to worry about people not watching because they're too busy being American.
I'd still be here, probably. Oh, invisible punches.
Oh yeah. Let me check something real quick. I was gonna say I actually did a show on the German equivalent of Independence Day, but I did not.
Mm.
I would have though, because you know, I can.
Mm.
So anyway, in kayfabe, this isn't Pride Month.
Mm.
Actually, in kayfabe, I have no idea what month it is.
Are there months on the moon?
It's a very good question. In kayfabe, time probably doesn't exist anymore.
Oh, of course not. We destroyed it with the women's tournament.
You know, I kind of want Helena to win, mainly because she's lost both other matches against Mel so far.
Yeah.
I think I bet on the wrong person, by the way, to play house. Well, life is pain.
Ah.
Oh, she's eating her face. Look at that.
Ah.
I kind of like that both her finishers, like, or that both Val's and Helena's resemble a kiss.
Hmm. I'm sure there's a reason for that.
If you squint real hard, yeah.
Also, well, DCB, we'll just have to go by the Rusevian calendar then. For every day is Rusev Day.
I actually, like, in my phone's calendar, I have an event for every day that just says it's Rusev Day.
Me too.
Like, I'm not joking, I actually have that. Because I'm an idiot.
Happy Rusev Day, everyone.
Yep, happy Rusev Day. Oh, I think Helen's confused there.
One, two.
And just some violence, you know. Oh, she's going for the kiss of death.
Can she get it?
Sefer, basically, Rusev Day is just that Rusev exists, and he says it's Rusev Day.
Yes.
And it's very good. There we go, Samooch, and one, two. Nope.
Yes, the gimmick of Rusev is awesome at everything he does. That's why we love him.
Also, he's Rusev.
Oh, yes.
She just keeps taunting. Wow, she got set up and just dropped down again. That normally doesn't happen. I think. I don't know. I'm not gonna claim to actually understand this game. Another kiss of death. This is number two. One, two. Ooh. that actually basically hit the ground, but the ref had to make the call.
Yeah. And now she's arguing with the ref and taunting. I guess that's one way of putting it, Zephyr.
It's the legendary DDT6 again.
Oh, Mara missed. Not even in her face.
Oh, she's eating her face again, I think. Nope, she isn't.
She's getting reversed.
Ooh, that was a headbutt.
Shoulder tackle. Shoulder tackle, I think.
I'm not sure. Maybe it looked like a headbutt to me. Oh, dirty pin. One. Two, and definitely not three, because a dirty pin, and it never works.
Valerie is going to have words with her over that one. Uh-oh. I'm stumped, I guess.
Well, working the arm, I guess. Even though she has no finisher or any move that targets the arm other than that. Oh, okay.
Roll up. The ref was off doing something else, I guess, because he didn't notice that.
I guess, yeah.
Busy fixing his bow tie. So say she was pulling Lotus there for a second.
Oh, another like move.
Nope. Kind of hits.
One, two, three. And that's 3-0 from Val.
Yeah. We have a new champ.
We do indeed have a new champ. Like in the tournament, she got eliminated early, I think. Actually, no, she got a free pass in the first round and then got eliminated.
Yes. Swaro is too busy fighting a box.
Yeah.
Also, I think Garbo Girl is there.
Something, something. I'm just gonna give everybody some extra points because I messed up playing house. If I get 50 twice, that's 100. 100! That's as many as 10 tens. I mean, Sephir, it changes. Last show we had, I think Rara won a match against the box, but we have no idea what it is now. It's kind of, yeah, it's weird. Well, their title suited Helena well, but I think that the red also goes well with the black dress.
Yeah.
Even though her color's technically blue.
It looks good on both of them.
It does. And considering that Rara is stuck inside the box, I don't think I could do that. But here we are, end of the show. The beach party is kind of over, I guess. I mean, it's probably an after party, but it's like, I don't know, for people who like to be social, which isn't me. So yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. This has been LBFWA Beach Party with matches that happened that were good, probably. So, since I've enjoyed myself, I'm just gonna be so rude to assume you did too. And wish you a good night. Or, no, wait.
See ya.
I have to say goodbye first, then good night. I screwed up. Whatever. See ya.
Bye.